An energy, you watch yourself.
Coming in hot over here. Welcome to What the Flick for Culture.
All right, we can't call it What the Flick anymore.
Yeah,
what Culture pointed out.
Oh no, I have to tell you. So this is what Mad contributes to your life. He doesn't do any research.
I did research.
So he named your show.
No, you didn't.
Okay, not specifically on this.
He named the show after two very successful podcasts. He's neither of them. So it's fantastic.
No, okay. First of all, I did not name it after those podcasts. It just so happens that they are, I guess, kind of like at my level, you know?
My level.
He was going to be YouTube, and then they fisted him.
Didn't work out.
No.
Wait, speaking of fisted, it's time for a brand new Movies with Mad / What
and
the Flick.
Friends.
No, Mad and Friends. Flick. Are you kidding me? All right, we have a special guest. I'll fix all this in post. And tonight we have a very special guest that should give us a few more views when I tag him
on
Twitter.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Culture Casino.
Oh, no, I was excited because Shred is here.
That all was, right. Has anybody ever heard of...
Bro, what's happening right now?
I'm trying to find.
He's got
to
find what the name of the movie is.
We're off to a strong start on Movies with Mad / What the Flick.
Hey, wait, rewind. Wait, I saw.
Here we go. Has anybody ever seen Undefeatable?
Oh, no. We're undefeatable.
No, I feel like that might not even be a word.
Has anybody ever seen Undefeatable?
No,
indefeatable. God,
no. Problem. So there's a name in here I recognize.
We haven't pressed play yet, so you haven't recognized anything.
Baloney, you freaking fast forwarded through it. I was watching it.
Culture, I'm cutting all this out.
Just editing that out.
All right, here we go now.
Why are we watching this?
Why do I invite you? My God, everybody has to be double positive to make up for Culture.
Yeah.
Why are you on camera? Culture. I'm not adding your camera footage.
You got to get into the spirit of this.
Donna Jason. That is
I'm very confused by that name.
That's two first names and they're different genders.
Right. No.
Well, I mean they're different sexes.
You never met a chick named Jason?
I don't play that game, Culture.
You've never met a chick named Jason?
All I know is Phil's a cook.
Well, we've got a chick named Jason on some of Comics Division shows.
What's happening?
Biological?
That's a lot of Asian names.
Not off to a great start for Mad. Just a close-up of a chick.
Hey, a close-up of a chick whose face looks like they never fired it in the kiln. Like
what?
It looks unfinished. It looks like raw clay. I don't like the look of her face. It's not the right fucking shape. It doesn't look human.
Time out. Wow.
What?
Who did that look like to you?
It sort of looked like the guy from Dark City.
But he's changed.
Kind of a early 90s
he's
action guy.
Violent.
So.
The guy
so
that's what, got the lazy eye?
What do you not like about her face?
I guess it looks unfinished.
It's not the right shape.
Yeah.
It's
a weird shape.
There are no lines in it at all.
God. All right, so who is this guy to you, Culture?
He looks kind of like Ian McShane.
He does.
Now, yeah.
But if he says cocksucker, we'll know.
White cocksucker. These two white cocksuckers. Who the fuck did it? Cocksucker.
Yeah. No. I think it'd be better if they actually hit each other.
Okay. Whatever. I'm just gonna keep going. This is some of the worst fucking shit. Just standing there, not moving your feet.
They call him death matches.
I like how we get her mouth sound.
They call him death matches?
Oh, is this blood sport?
No, it's Kuma sport.
Kumite?
No. It's sport a K.
For a K? Oh, so Shredda can't see it.
What the fuck, dude? You're not Martin Scorsese. This is not Raging Bull.
You can't see it, Shredder. It's in 4K.
Oh, this
what
guy's
do you mean?
Dead.
There's things happening?
That's not legal. You can't do that. You can't
he says
elbow.
He's fighting. She says he's fighting in death matches.
Yeah,
dude, why have gloves?
This isn't boxing.
Death matches with boxing gloves.
In a ring.
With nobody watching.
Right. Right.
Maybe you could talk to him.
She has the eye acting of L.A. Noir.
Press X to doubt.
Come to on his own. In the meantime, you have to do what's good for you.
By the way,
this one's off to a strong start.
Look at the eye acting.
Wait.
Either that or she's on Twitch.
Okay, wait.
They're going to cut away. They'll cut back because she couldn't cry on command.
I know. Ready. Bam!
What's good for you.
Dude, okay. So, seriously, that's like a Visine tier. Like, they loaded her up.
That is some thick real tier.
Did you just say you think it's real, Shredda?
Yep.
No, that's a thick tier. That is a real thick tier.
Yeah. Yeah,
that, it has the viscosity that does not remind me of what comes out of a human eyeball.
Yep, that tear has a lot of junk in the trunk.
I never thought I'd see a woman with Robert Zadora's jaw.
It's okay. I'm not the only one then.
Oh man.
It's kind of cabbage patchy.
Oh, yes, I can't
see
that.
She does look like I have a cabbage, and her eyes are super cabbage close patch together.
Don't they have a dimple
fucking
in their chin,
V8?
Though? All the Cabbage Patch?
Dude, maybe. Y'all remember that movie, what was it, Ninja 3, where the chick pours the VA on that dude's hairy chest?
Oh, yeah.
Ninja
man.
3, The Domination. I made you guys watch that one. That is a canon film, by the way. It is a Golan Globus production.
That was a good one, too.
He stole this Take a Penny stuff.
Oh, no.
How dare you?
Well, I mean, he did give him a free Coke. Oh, you just messed with the wrong Oriental kid.
Asians are persons of color, too. Guy.
Well, I was waiting for him to pull a David Caruso line and then hear the Who.
Well, that's not fair. You gave the kid his for free.
Yeah.
Or maybe you're just too much of a chicken shit to pick on someone your own size.
Oh, boy.
First of all, in what world did these two hang out?
Yeah, who's this fucking dude off to the left? They're expensive.
That dude's got the face of a Mack truck.
Man, the lines here, they're hitting hard.
Just a couple of pumps giving me a warm-up.
Well, this is the 80s. Maybe.
What is happening? Who are these people?
Gangs are meeting the mafia.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh.
So,
oh, my God.
And
what?
The Brotherhood.
They're not believer, right?
You're such a friend.
Is that really Cindy
what?
Rockford?
What? She said you're such a friend?
Is this like five corners like and this is neutral turf?
I'm going back to my place.
Because you're going to be too busy looking for your teeth.
Oh.
So it's going to be like that, huh?
Yeah, it's going to be like that.
All right, same game, same rules. Here's the money.
Oh my God, this reminds me of Lionheart.
It reminds me of fucking
Mortal Kombat!
Miami
Connection. Anchorman,
dude. Okay, all right. So the champion sweatshirt was not a bridge too far, and neither was the chain.
Wait,
or the spike gauntlets on his arms.
There's not even that many people watching. Most of it's just like their entourage. What is what is this? Oh, what? The Jets versus Sharks was more believable.
Wait, you're a jet all the way from your first cigarette.
I should nobody make any music references.
I mean, I just sang it, you fucking asshole.
Well, it's gonna be edited out.
Oh no, he turned.
Oh my God,
that's getting real now.
Yeah, that was like best of the best.
In a fight like this, I will tell you right now, I would immediately stop and be like, can you guys stop fucking clapping?
I'm trying to concentrate.
I need a rhythm for this fight.
Look at her head. Her head says nasty girl.
Nasty girl. What is she, Janet Jackson from 1988?
It's not going to be
all
a
these
dance
people
battle.
Are throwing off the timing, and she's going to turn around and be like, "These are my friends."
Dude, even if it's a dance battle, they don't have good rhythm either.
Right? They look like they're struggling to keep up.
And I feel like they're a part of the Rhythm Nation with those hats.
Nasty boy and nasty girl. Do you think they're together?
I don't know why I had Rhythm of the Night pop in my head.
Well, brother and sister.
Well, DeBarge was married to Janet.
Yeah. And the chick on the far right looks like she's worked in Vegas, and I'm not talking about on the stage.
What? So a waitress?
Yeah.
She dealt cards?
Just like a regular
a dealer?
Person.
She was at the craps?
Didn't make any money.
No, I mean, okay, so there's a difference.
Valet?
Wait, no, there's a difference between a hooker and an escort. And she's the...
She wouldn't be able to make it either.
No.
I
want to hear the difference. I want to hear the difference between a hooker and an escort, please.
Yes, let us explain.
Can we move on?
No.
Escorts are classic.
She might have made it onto one of those old style Vegas cards that they used to flick and hand out to everybody.
Oh yeah, like
they still give those out. Yeah,
but no.
Yeah, but not like they used to.
That Burke, the promotion on those is very expensive. I mean, those guys cost like $4 a card.
Man, you have a lot of knowledge about the escorts and whores of Las Vegas.
Hey, I have friends.
I feel like Culture's the guy who was at the strip club that got in trouble when he was like, "I thought all exotic dancers were prostitutes."
him and his college roommate going around like trying to be the white iceberg Slim.
He has actually enough money to make your life really sad, man. So I wouldn't say any of that.
I didn't say anything negative. I'm a big fan of Iceberg Slim.
He's just trying to figure it out.
So is this movie where they first started combining the Asians and whites as one group?
And yet we don't have a single Asian fighting in this martial arts battle.
Okay, right now we don't even have a Blasian.
They have matching do-rags.
Dude.
Oh, God. Ow. Matching matching gangs are the best. There was this gang, this local gang, and they were called the White T-Shirt Gang. And they claimed affiliation with Folk Nation.
Wait, local here?
Yeah.
How were they associated
to you? You got to watch out for their offshoot, the Plain White Tees. They were a terrible gang to deal with.
They had no affiliation. Yeah, but so they all wore white T-shirts. I pulled them over one night. I've dealt with these guys many times. I'm like, man,
all of them at once?
Are you being serious?
Yeah, It was an SUV. They're like 15, 16. They're pretending to be gangsters.
So, okay, did you notice the detail in this film, though, before you continue this story?
Sure, this sounds important.
There's blood on the wall.
Your big disgrace.
Where her face was?
Yeah.
Well, she did just hit the wall pretty hard.
No,
right?
But I mean, there's like, it's like almost realism.
Well, I mean, Brahma, she doesn't look great, but I wouldn't say she hit the wall just
right. She is of a certain age, little Chad.
Oh my God.
She hit the wall.
Anyways.
Anyways.
Battle Alley. So
I pulled over
Battle Alley.
I pulled over an SUV filled with like 5-6 of them, right? And I was like, dude, I gotta ask, when you picked up the first dude, were you like, oh man, you're wearing a white t-shirt tonight too, man, this is ridiculous? at what point did you realize, you know what, guys, we gotta rethink what we're gonna our outfits for tonight? Okay, we cannot all be wearing the same thing.
And that's when Matt decided he needed to get into community outreach, because he saw a bunch of kids carrying these unopened Hanes white t-shirt packages, and he was like, oh shit, they're about
the black
to get
market
into
on those
trouble.
Things.
Were ranks delineated by like if you wore a V-neck, you were high ranking, but the crew necks, they were the rank and file kind of guys.
Well, and imagine anybody who pulled their sleeves off were the enforcers.
So it kind of worked like the chevrons for a sergeant. If you had three white t-shirts on, that would, you know, represent.
Oh my God, no!
I'm joking.
Did any of them roll their cigarette packs up into their sleeve?
No, they were all underage. They couldn't smoke.
Yeah, that just
sounds like a gang member.
Boy, crazy. The gang unit sent down a memo to the rest of the cops, the beat cops. He was like, "Look, Costco got a run on all their white t-shirts. They all sold out. We know shit's about to go down.
It's gonna go down.
Something's gonna happen.
No bullshit, babe. You remember that dude Patrick I told you about that tried to eat his weed and then pissed at the sound of my voice, pissed his pants?
Yeah, obviously.
Okay, he was in the white t-shirt gang.
Okay, can I ask you, at what point is eating your weed a good plan?
Dude,
did he piss because
it worked out in Super Troopers?
No, no, no. All right, no, listen. So I've dealt with him multiple times up to this point, and I just got shipped, and they already had him pulled over. I go out, and I could hear him yelling at his mom on the phone, like, "Patrick, get off the damn phone." He goes, "Oh shit." I'm like, "Get out the car," and he gets out the car, and he has shake all over the front of him. I'm like, "Bro, what is all this?" He goes, "It's oregano." What? You were making a pizza in the back seat? I was like, "Don't touch it. Just turn around." And I put him in handcuffs. And then I could smell the weed coming off his breath. I'm like, "Patrick, open your fucking mouth." And there's just fucking flakes of weed in his teeth. I'm like,
"Green teeth."
I said, "Do not tell me you tried eating your fucking bag." He goes, "No, I had a green Gatorade." Motherfucker, they don't make cannabis flavor. What are you talking about?
Yeah, and last I checked, Gatorade isn't chunky.
Right. So I stayed with the other two guys and was going to process the car and all the evidence, bullshit like that, while the female officer and the new guy who was left seat, right seat, they took him back. I get back to the station, and Diaz, the chick, comes up. She goes, "Oh, my God, so you're not going to believe," she was kind of ghetto, "what happened." I'm like, "What's up?" So we're on our way back, and I started smelling something. And I went, "Patrick, did you piss yourself?" And he goes, "Yeah, just a little bit." "Why the fuck did you do that?" He goes, "I don't know. I just heard Officer Matt," because that's what he called me, Officer Matt. "I heard his voice, and I just knew what was going to happen next." Yes.
The casual raping?
Yeah, of course.
Obviously.
No, that's Officer Brahma that does that.
I'm going to say this right now. I need more booze. I'll be right back. Holy shit.
All right, let's
Meanwhile,
keep going.
Matt now does eat his weed.
Yeah, I guess you're right. But
it's
true.
You saw him doing it, and you were like, "I think that kid's onto something."
He's like, "What if we made it in gummy form? If only it was in a gummy form." And then
what is this?
This is Brahma's casual raping demonstration.
This is the most realistic fight between a man and a woman I've seen in 20 years.
She's gonna rip her chains. They didn't have.
You're not allowed to touch the ground.
Oh, never mind.
Maybe that was the whole premise.
Wait a minute. Did you actually start the movie when I went to go get a drink?
Yeah, bro, because we have to keep pausing for you. We're trying to make some headway. It's already midnight.
He did it immediately. The chick won
$600.
Yeah, because she beat the black guy somehow.
Actually,
in
I knew
a fist
her.
Fight.
I knew that girl.
What do you mean you knew her? Like in a biblical way?
I mean, I don't know.
Like coitus?
From Vegas?
Squidditch?
By the way, I love 80s mom's pants like that that show off the whole shapely booty.
Oh, I hate the high-waisted crap.
So horrible.
Yeah, I don't like high-waisted pants. They look weird.
Get on my level.
Am I supposed to believe that she is like a college-aged girl?
No, there's no way. That was her granddaughter in that last scene.
Because they were talking. Yeah, she's pretty.
Okay, so she's the most feminine-looking so far.
I don't know about that. She got like kind of a monster nose.
Yeah.
The psychiatrist was probably the most feminine.
I'm pretty sure.
Actually, the girl fighting was pretty feminine.
This is
the
girl
fighting.
Yeah, that's cool. That's Cynthia Rothrock star.
She hit that wall harder than I thought then.
Is there a normal looking guy in this fucking movie?
There's not a normal looking anyone in this fucking movie.
The 80s were a difficult time.
This was from the 90s culture.
You know what? Even the 90s, though, she actually could be like 19, 20 years old. Everybody looked 15 years older than they were supposed to.
I looked it up. She's 33 in this movie.
Here?
That's how old she actually is.
She's in her 30s. Big deal.
I have bills to pay. And you say, I hit the wall.
But you're right. This was the 90s. So it's like 90210 rules. They could have had a 33-year-old playing a 19-year-old.
I hope he explains the broken window. Is this preppy looking kid outside asking for her? Damn.
Oh, look, he's a major in the white t-shirt gang with the
white
button-up.
It's a different gang.
Come on, Mark Paul Gosselaar.
Aw.
Zach Morris is trash.
Peace.
No time served, though.
Wait, for disturbing the peace? I would hope there was no time served.
Hey, hey, whoa, this movie got more interesting.
Oh, boy. We may have to go to my backup movie.
They're on different beds. This is their dorm room.
Wait, they're in a dorm?
You didn't realize she's a just 18-year-old college girl trying to find how, you know, her own way?
Oh, shit, the white scarf gang.
Oh, this is going to be a runner, huh?
That guy has
a mullet. What the fuck?
Wow. Hold on. Liam McShane
Hold on.
Why is she not chewing his ass out? I am positive he just threw his jacket directly on the fucking floor.
This is Brahma's casual entrance every time.
We're getting casual.
Wait, are they married?
Apparently.
That's important context.
He just brought her flowers, and they've got the wine set out for their anniversary.
Oh, yeah, they're married.
Whoa.
Why is this being filmed like it's sexy?
Like, grab the White Zinfandel and crack him across the fucking head.
Oh, boy, this shit's going to go. Don't bother making jokes. A lot of this is going to be cut out.
You have to cut this.
What the fuck just happened?
Wait, no.
Okay. Rewind it. I gotta say.
I'm back in, baby.
What he's doing is still wrong, but I gotta give respect where it's due.
Yeah. Give him his props.
Okay, hell of a move.
Wait, why are we cutting? Because, you know, everybody knows that a sizzling steak represents rape.
What I know is that this is going to burn a steak.
I'm sorry.
Why is he fantasizing about beating up the other guy?
Stop, Matt. Before you get going on this subject, I know the path you're going down. I'm just gonna say, beach volleyball.
You're kind of right. Yeah, but like, I get it. Why you would think of a bro so you could keep your erection? You know what I mean?
I don't think he's thinking of a bro. I think he's thinking of beating up a black guy.
No, it's beach volleyball.
You think racism is his Viagra? Wait.
How does the top of the steak get burnt?
I'm
does
mad.
Take a break and go flip it.
There you go.
That's how all anniversaries should go.
So is this our hero of the movie?
Matt, did you just ask if that was your? This is the hero.
I'm just asking if that's the protagonist. Maybe it's a redemption arc.
He is indefeatable.
Enjoy it while you can, Stingray. Monday, we're back in the gym.
His name is Stingray?
Stingray, like the guy from freaking Cobra Kai?
I am not your mother.
What?
Wait a second.
Wait a minute. Did he rape his mother?
Wait. Every time you call me mommy?
Why am I only a person? I'm the only person on camera. Why?
I don't know. It's not going to be added to the video, and this is being edited out.
All it is is our avatars at the bottom of the screen.
Yeah,
we've
mentioned this before.
Yeah.
If you would go into avatar mode, you could at least see your bubble making, you know.
Oh, that's right. I'm doing that now. Yeah, way to fuck it up, culture.
Wait, what are you doing?
I am so unhappy.
Oh my god, he stood up with such rage.
He's actually twitching his ears.
I want to remind Mad real quickly, I have four attorneys.
Okay. And I have no money.
No, please.
Mommy, don't go. This is great acting.
His eyes are a different color now, right?
Yeah, they're brown now. His eyes are blue later.
I mean, if
that's
you're going to have different
his mom color. Smacked the brown out of his eyes, and that's why he left him blue.
Motherfucking montage! Gonna go find my wife!
I'll find you.
Oh.
So is he the good guy in this
movie? Yeah, I think he's our protagonist.
It seems like they're setting him up as the protagonist.
What is happening? You're killing the ozone layer.
No, that's not Aquanet. He's putting red streaks in his hair.
He's going undercover.
I will find you.
And die.
She can't hear you. Oh, she's already out with another guy.
No, I think he's so angry that he'll even beat up someone who looks like his wife.
Mucky Wrench didn't come out until way later.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Genetically, he should be okay here.
Wow.
See? What did I tell you?
I wasn't... No. Every Asian person doesn't know...
Are you a geneticologist?
Yeah, you're insane. Yeah. Have you ever gotten kicked by X-ray girl? They all know it.
And maybe every Asian person doesn't, but every Asian person in a 90s movie does.
You're goddamn right they do. What the... What the fuck?
He blinded
him. Did he just rip out his eye?
What the fuck?
The eye gouge?
That actually
left a mark.
That
was a good stunt.
Yeah. Okay. All right, movie. You're winning me back over.
I mean, they killed an Asian guy to do it, but I mean,
well, we don't know if he's dead. We don't know if he's dead.
I feel like he might be the bad guy. That might be the bad guy.
Yeah, Matt is still on the list.
You don't know how these movies go, obviously.
You don't. No. That is our hero.
What happened with Jared from Subway?
Started the diet.
Are you serious?
What?
What?
You know he's been in prison for years, right?
Time out.
What happened?
Somebody help her.
Are you doing a bit?
Jared got skinny, no. Then stuck his dick in kids.
Is that how that works?
No. Are you seriously? You did not
you
know.
You did not know he's a fan of the playground.
That this better not be a work.
I wanted to hear somebody.
Oh, I knew it. I knew it was a work. Yeah, bro, that's their office. Okay, they're an upstart promotion.
What in the fuck?
What? Who?
We're just getting more and more casual.
Stay hard here. What? It was a soft chain.
Nerf. It was a Nerf chain.
Yeah, yeah.
He hadn't gotten it hard yet.
They made it out of foam. It just makes the jingling sound with a little speaker in the handle.
It was a flaccid chain. It wasn't hard yet.
Oh, okay.
He's got a broken nose.
Chad elaborated. It worked better.
Wait, hold on.
His eyes were torn out.
He starts with... he has a broken nose?
What do we have here, guys?
We all have ISO recordings culture. We clip together whatever works.
Why didn't you start with the eye thing?
Why, Matt, look at the way his handcuffs are in there. He's just stuffed them down one side.
I do think I know where Matt was trying to go with that, though. You'd think you'd lead with guy's eyes were torn out.
Okay, so first of all, that's the best use of ketchup I've seen in a long time.
Oh my god, like you could identify Asian blood.
I have very full lips, which is a huge problem because ladies just want to kiss me all the time.
You got large labia, huh?
This is going to be another two-nighter.
I hate you, Romo.
I mean, like, are we talking Arby's roast beef or what are we talking?
Oh man,
like Britney Spears.
you realize there will be punishment for this.
Oh man, your labia is as big as your Gamora.
Casual punishment.
Also, founder.
Ooh, founder. That doesn't look good.
Finders keepers.
Tortured in rape. I love how he's.
Might personally make sure the photographers get a shot of this. I want the reporters kept out of here.
What?
Oh, photographers.
Make sure the photographers get a shot of this. I don't want any reporters to know.
I love that he could eyeball the rape. Raped.
Oh, was that an eyeball missing joke?
No. Cyber cop.
The hockey pads gang.
No.
That's football pads.
Football pads gang.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
That's not. That's
oh,
no.
Oh my god, no.
Oh god, dang it, Slender.
Whoa, we went all the way back to the rape.
I own Showbiz Pizza.
Wait,
why are you?
What?
Would you guys?
You wore a colander on your head.
What? Why did we go back that far?
Because Slender made me accidentally go to the beginning.
Wait, go Slender.
Wait, did he just get down in the 3-point?
He did.
Yes.
Yeah.
Why is his jersey on backwards? And Steelers. Wait, hold on. What the fuck?
Yeah, so
there's
many
not
questions.
A player on the Steelers named Steelers.
Here it is. That's a beard, douche dude.
It's beard-ish, but I like how he did it like it was blood. You can't touch the ground.
I don't know what it is, but in the fight scenes, she looks pretty good. Son of a bitch!
No, daughter of a bitch.
Is that Kathy Najimy?
So Cynthia Rothrock was actually a legit like martial artist.
Yeah, she could actually fight.
Yeah, for women, yes, she was pretty good.
She got recruited to be a movie.
I tell you what, person. Mad.
Mm-hmm.
I still don't think you could kick her ass.
Wait, the chick is carrying his shoulder pads for him.
Oh, they have a really good.
After the fight, he took them off, and she's carrying him.
Oh my god.
I hope he doesn't do worse than the chick did against this guy. Oh no, he doesn't have his shoulder pads. What is he gonna do?
Oh, this is gonna be bad.
Oh no! Oh, he gets roadhoused him.
He's got the cross on. Is he doing this for Jesus? Is he gonna tear phone books next?
How dare you?
Yeah, he's not doing it very fast.
He's doing cop kata.
He killed that guy. And then he took the girl somewhere else.
Yes. Killed and then her, dropped her back off. Right.
Brought her back to the scene of the crime.
Yes. Put her in the porta potty.
But you forgot he also casually Brahma'd her before he brought her back to.
No, yeah. Yes. Oh, no. We were more concerned
with
like
becoming
the
a verb.
Wait. No, you are. I've seen the
book. I'm just confused as to why he brought the body back.
Let me just clear this up real quick. After he Brahma-fied her, he brought her back. And then dumped her into the porta potty. And that's how they came across her.
All right. Well,
Yes, sir.
Boy, he had some
eyeliner.
I feel
like the one guy
he
was getting ready to be on Twitch the way he was oiled up.
And
I
with
feel
his
like
mascara.
They're both a little gay for each other.
Okay. A little bro for each other.
Little too bro.
Who is this? Why does she have the body of a midget but not the height?
That is interesting. For a drink and make it up to me. No, slut.
Did she say he could sit on her face?
God,
oh
there's
shit!
Nothing.
There's another girl who looks like his wife.
Oh,
there's nothing worse. There's nothing worse than the woman that you know is willing to do it. But because there's
is
no
the
black
president
chick.
From Battlestar Galactica.
God damn it, Brahma, every time.
Hey, I do running jokes every now and then, assholes.
Yeah, but usually they're better than that.
You do jokes?
It'll play.
This guy is not getting out of the way.
I love that he left the girl willing to have sex with him to come after her because he knows she won't.
He just every girl is Anna to him. Anna, you're
coming with me. So is this movie a prequel to Frozen?
I don't understand.
Let her go.
Bitch, we can see your panties.
Yeah, oh. Seriously.
And he has a good ripping move.
Yeah. Man, you think he's gonna do that throat rip, but on her vagina?
Right in the middle of a fight.
Man, he's about to tear off your labia and Gamora.
Oh my god.
There's some more ocular cavities.
Ew.
You think he fucks the... Oh, dude, did he leave? That's fucking my... This motherfucker...
He said he had to refresh.
You know you just fucked my audio.
The recording, the ISO recording culture.
What?
You probably just jacked up the ISO recording.
I doubt it.
It's fine. I was only going to use like 10% of what he said anyways.
Wow.
That 10 he's minutes mostly... while you were smoking?
No. He's mostly here for the tag. I don't even know what's happening right now. Oh, her sister's dead.
Apparently that's his sister, or her sister, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The one...
They're shipping boxes that we use for vacuum tubes and things like that.
No, yeah, bro.
Those are most definitely Pizza Hut pizza boxes, unfolded.
Oh,
yeah, there was...
So and these they will give you a cardboard cut like you would not believe.
Oh, they are headed to Epstein Island, is what you're saying.
And here's the
wait,
thing.
Was he a big fan of pizza?
Yes.
I don't know, but all of them seem to be.
Oh, I
get
it.
Matt, to answer your question.
Yeah, it clicked for me too.
To answer your question, Matt, none of what he did on top of those boxes was martial arts. I don't know what it was, but it wasn't martial arts.
Are you looking for something?
Yes.
A fight. I'm looking for you, Lee. Oh? Mr. Jones.
the Red Dragons.
Wait, her nickname is the Red Dragon?
No, it's
her.
And they wear no red.
I think
that's because she's got red hair. I give the patch on them.
I guess.
Heard you've been busy lately.
Who sent you here?
Oh, she thinks
maybe
he's
she
the
wins
killer?
The fight because she can't have a reflection in a mirror.
Oh my god, he has claws.
There are some who call me Brie Larson.
There's some that call me. Wait, is he a cat?
Wait, pause. They stole this scene. This is in Ip Man. It's in, I think, the fourth one.
Oh, you mean IP Man?
Yeah.
Are you talking about the movie that came out like 18 years after this one?
Yeah, the one with Mike Tyson.
What I'm saying is Ip Man stole it from this movie.
Oh, okay. I thought you were saying the opposite.
That's where I was going. Reversed. I was like, yeah.
Interestingly enough, her gloves there
don't match shit.
And they only cover the fingers.
Yeah, what are the point of these?
The one thing you want to protect is the knuckles.
Yeah, what I think is interesting is that they're not red because she's the Red Dragons. They're orange dragons.
Well, that would just be tacky.
They're the Red Dragons because she's a ginger. Slow. Well, it's in the barrels.
Oh, my God. He almost got her. Ow, you scratched the back of my head.
Oh, no. She's going to...
Oh, he's going to blow... Yes!
Oh, he's
dead. Wow.
And Canadian, probably.
Nobody makes my hair fall.
If I were to compare him to anybody, it would be Michael McNamara.
The lesser
better of the McNamaras.
What? It didn't feel good.
I don't know, but I never saw his hand touch the ground, so I don't think the fight's over.
I don't think that was a
yeah, I don't think
fight.
That was sanctioned.
Yeah.
That's the rules, Mad. We've established it in the movie.
Well, no, only
and
sanctioned.
Has to touch the ground.
Just get in the car.
You want to tell me why you were over on the north side fighting the Eagles?
Fighting the Eagles? Did they just let this whole fighting thing?
We hate the Eagles.
Well, you know, most police departments have a homicide division. They have a fight division.
Oh, she's about to tell him that she noticed a wound on the body that came from a specific fighting style, and that's why she thought it was this dude.
I swear to God, if you guessed correctly.
He did.
Does the homicide division also have curling iron in the bathroom? Because how did her hair go from straight to fluff?
I don't know what this is.
Nice. Fuck you, Chad. Fuck you. You thought you.
No, fuck you,
Chad. Hold on. Let me finish. Fuck you, Chad. Because you were like, the girl figured out she's going to say that it was a certain move. He's like, dumb. That wasn't the move. That wasn't the Eagles.
No, I said that's why she went to attack him. I didn't. She was clearly wrong.
You were right and you denied it.
No, and it's interesting because you didn't let him finish, so it's hard to dispute. And I think Slender probably has some insight, but you know.
Wait, on what he said? I'll check it in the record. I'll check it in the editing. And if it makes it to the final cut, then you'll know.
I heard nothing.
I was right.
Rewind, because he was.
Okay. Why are you touching her? Ugh, why that long? What the fuck? Bro, this is not appropriate.
Yeah, you didn't do that more than four or five times when you were a cop.
Not to the girls.
He usually cupped the guy's tits.
Well, yeah, you gotta do a credit card swipe before you put them in.
Yeah.
Sorry, hold on. To put them into the cell, I didn't want anybody to think something.
Sure.
Well, I think you said what you meant, Matt. Come on, Mike.
When did we get back to our protagonist?
Right?
I was actually
intrigued by his story.
Coca-Cola must have paid for product placement in this movie because
they uncurled her hair. Drinking.
Yeah, how did her hair go from straight
and
curl and then straight again?
Yeah. Her hair is as consistent as her ability to fight.
Actually,
the guy at the club was hassling this pretty blonde, and I thought
his voice is the same pitch and tenor as hers,
as in every other Asian in this movie.
What are you showing us, dude?
Otherwise, I'd be dead.
What?
Some guy named Ryko from the Maniacs.
The Maniacs.
maniacs on the floor.
Thank you, Slender.
Oh, I was gonna go maniacs, come out and play.
What is up with him? Let's do it. By the way, this is what happens when you let Democrats run your city. It gets overtaken by gangs. They start underground tournaments.
This is clearly San Francisco. You are the
one who finger lead. Oh, because of all the Asians?
Yeah, and I thought they were trying to get to the bottom of underground death matches, but
right.
I've never seen a death match where the second your hand touches the ground, you lose.
Oh, they did. No, hold on. The only thing that was called a death match was our protagonist's fight.
Yeah.
That's true. That's true.
Look into my eyes, and you will see. Oh, my God. They got so offended because she said asshole.
The double chair kick.
The fuck is happening?
What the fuck? What? By the way, that was a dude with a wig.
That was pretty good. That was,
his
that
hand
was
a, touched the ground. I saw it.
I don't think this it isn't a, sanctioned.
That was a pretty good double roll.
The mafia guys was were just that. There.
Okay.
Oh yeah, this is actually sanctioned.
Okay, so ow. So oh wow.
Okay, now I don't understand. Is it like wrestling? They have to be pinned?
They're not doing a sanctioned
fight. Well, the mafia guys left. So yeah, maybe
did they leave?
No.
Oh wow. That's gonna be a piece of
wood. You don't like this?
Let's go! Now everybody's gonna fight. Oh, I love this.
These are my friends.
Hey.
There's our luxury car driving.
That's my line, by the way. You're going to be charged for that.
I'll edit it out. Don't worry, Brum. I got you.
Yeah, until Mad steals it, and then it'll become his own.
No, it's my line, bitches.
What's your line?
Oh, I guess you've never done a movie with Mad. Where
these are my
what
friends.
The fuck are you saying, Chad?
All right, he shot twice. He's only got 4 bullets left with 13 people.
Matt, is it part of the use of force continuum to discharge your weapon to gain power?
Only twice. It's no different than an office pop.
And it was not his gun. You got a lot to learn about police
work. Wait, whose gun is that?
Was she doing police work?
No,
I'm talking about you,
man. I think she's contracted.
Oh, she's a consultant.
This was the best outfit she had to go to her sister's funeral.
Yeah.
You were all brown to your sister. Oh.
Hey, I feel like the Rose Tico outfit is overplayed right now. Thank
you. Karen really respected you. I'm not adding that clip.
You suck.
Her shoulder pads are insane.
Mad, you know what's crazy?
What's wrong?
She's wearing the same outfit as Rose Tico from The Last Jedi.
What? Oh, shit, Chad. Definitely adding that clip.
Time for a holdo maneuver.
You white people bust me up.
By the way, is she wearing the shoulder pads from the football player? The one on the left?
Yeah, well, she costumed, so.
Yeah,
that's just win a mile from then.
Look, you keep what you kill.
They all have shoulders that way.
You keep what you kill. That's all I have to say.
She wasn't even there. My dick.
What?
He wants her to
brought in a specialist.
I love that her only.
I want to see this specialist.
The only way that she can contribute is through her knowledge of martial arts. And they're like, no, dumb. We're bringing in a guy. We're bringing in a man.
We're bringing in someone who actually knows stuff. Claw techniques,
such as the tiger claw, please.
They hired this martial arts expert. That guy's never done martial arts in his life. He runs the ramen stand outside the police station.
Oh, come on. Look at those lips. Nothing says kung fu.
Oh, yeah. I got the lips. I'm holding my hands a certain way, and I'm wearing that kind of shirt. Clearly, I know martial arts.
Confucius
has large facial labia.
Confucius say, before you strike, pucker up.
I could eat a peach all day.
Oh, God.
Face off. Got that one.
You can shake my tree. No, I want to shake your tree. Whatever. I'm a joker.
A monster.
Now rewind. I mean, Rewind. Now that's boss level chick right there. Oh boy. Okay, that chick has never seen a salad.
Oh boy.
What the fuck? This is the saddest trailer I've ever seen.
This is a trailer?
This is a trailer?
Trailer for the film?
No, trailer, no, they're home. Living in a trailer. Yeah.
Oh, mobile park.
Oh, okay.
This is some of the worst police work I've ever seen.
Yeah, but
and I've seen Hangman.
Okay,
the psychiatrist is going to be the one that talked to Anna.
Calm down. Look at his shirt.
Uh huh. Yeah, very nice. Professional. Yeah.
That is a purple paisley shirt.
It looks like one of the, you know, the back of the cereal box where you had to stare at and cross your eyes to see the picture.
Yes.
That's what that shirt is.
Supply's going to be like, where's the freaking sailboat?
You dumb bastard. It's not a schooner. It's a sailboat.
I know. And that
you're going to have to send me the link to that. I don't
remember. I used to make fun of people.
Mall rats.
Mall rats.
I can see all
those
things.
Wait, you can't see them.
You can't see those?
No, there's
your
no way
eyes
you can
are
see
way
a Treader.
Too feminine.
You can't see 3D.
Wait, no.
3D
calm down. Those are things that I always can see. They
calm
are
down.
Not in 4K. They're like bullshit. You know how I know? Because I used to have a whole two books filled with them, and I saw 3-1.
Wait,
see, this
you can
is
see
I like about Shredda.
All I know
most
is that
chicks have more cones than rods, but Shredda's got more rods than cones.
All
Matt,
I know is
I knew you were gay.
Everybody calm down. Shredda clearly can't see anything because she, I mean, look at this. This shirt is like a Where's Waldo of amazingness, and she's never seen anything in one of those.
I can't believe we all stopped for that.
I mean, that's like a cornucopia of amazing in that shirt.
You know what? You know what? You know how I can actually see? It reminds me of the old analog TVs. When.
Oh, wait. Is this Anna's therapist?
It is.
Yes.
As I mentioned.
Okay. What I appreciate about her is the narrowness of her jaw at the end. Like, it's actually pointed. She doesn't have the jawline of a man.
No, she has the jawline of the Wicked Witch of the West.
Which is fine.
I think that's she fine. Has a nice face shape by comparison to any of the other women so far. Well,
bro, there has been no reason for him to think any of these people were Anna. He just does it.
Hey,
dude, as far as I can tell, anyone with dark colored hair, like, he have ignored the blonde girl, but then he immediately looked at a redhead.
That's a federal offense right there.
Oh, how do you know he's not at his house?
It's not his house.
Also, by the way, the thing about the blonde, though, that was the only one willing to have sex with him, so that was an instant. No, he's never going to get it up.
That's true. He can't really enjoy that.
Oh, wait. Sure looks a lot like his house.
It could be.
Wasn't even cooking a steak.
Oh, no.
That salad is still on the goddamn
table. Throw the jacket
table.
On the floor.
Throw it.
No. Oh.
Well,
he did a lot better that time.
Yeah, he's evolving.
Well, I mean, technically, he doesn't have her to clean it up anymore.
Or to bitch at him about it, so. Jennifer Simmons.
What?
How did the mail get on the floor? Did he throw the mail on the ground?
Yes.
You ever feel like some of these people need a dermatologist? Okay, it's just me.
I love how even the movie went silent on that one.
If you're gonna go to should have been 3 days ago.
No. Is it?
I can't continue helping you unless I do.
Yes, you can. One, you don't have anything else to offer. You have nothing else to offer this investigation. Good job. You gave him a little piece of information. And stay in your car until
I get. Who is he?
Paul Taylor. Goes by the street name Stingray. You know him?
The street name. No, you haven't.
Okay, so she went to the she went to the Desilu studio to get those sunglasses.
Did you hear what she said? No, he's pretty brutal though. That's why they call him Stingray. What?
I don't know. Ash,
you should see what you should see what he did to
the crocodile
Steve
hunter.
Irwin. Yes,
Steve Irwin. Yeah.
Okay, let's try that again. Wait, rewind because rewind because that joke needs to be better delivered. Because
no, we don't have to rewind it.
Just
editing.
Okay, do the
because
joke.
Chad
back.
Couldn't remember the name.
Yeah, we don't give Chad redos on his jokes.
Yeah.
I've
thought about doing ADR.
No, that's a really important joke.
Was it?
Yes.
I mean, look, I Chad has had some bangers.
No, give him this joke. Just.
Oh my God. Okay, here
Chad,
we go.
Go ahead, right. Dude.
Jesus Christ! Everybody,
now
reset
this is a lot of pressure.
No. Right? Don't fuck this up because this is the first time we've ever done anything like this.
No.
And if you fuck it up now, we're never doing it again.
Yep. Slender, hold on. Why do they call him Stingray?
Okay. That's why they call him the Stingray.
Because he's brutal? Are stingrays known for their brutality?
That's Steve Irwin
really
thinks so.
Steve Irwin.
I don't know. Ask the crocodile hunter, bitch.
I don't know. Why don't you talk to Crocodile Dundee?
Okay. None of those were good. I feel like we wasted that moment in time.
That's what we tried
well,
to
now,
tell you.
Well, at least now we know. By the name of Lou Dembski. Not, that way we don't have to do it again.
You all week. What have you been doing?
Murdering girls.
Yeah.
Oh my
people.
God, he's trying so hard to look crazy.
He's not doing a good job. On you, Stingray. I can look crazy.
Oh,
in about
it seems like
minutes.
His relaxed face to me.
Damn. I came across, you know, P. Diddy's in trouble, right? Because of some allegations or whatever.
Yeah.
I saw a tweet that said,
"Oh wait.
Netflix needs to do a documentary called P. Diddy or Did He?"
Look, this is like. This is bad. This is Mary Tyler Moore hairstyle bad that we're eating.
Hey, so did you hear P. Diddy's in trouble?
God.
Oh,
is it because he accused of casually Brahmaing some girls?
Oh, he Brahmified a couple of guys. Anyways,
guys?
I want to see. Yeah. Oh, he's gay. Yeah. I want to see a Netflix documentary called P. Diddy or Did He? Nailed it.
Did he pee in a 17-year-old?
Okay, time out. Okay, I'm offended right now because I was told that we didn't redo joke segments for the show.
Well, look at what you've started. Chad. You've opened the gate.
Yeah, we're redoing them all.
Pandora's
now.
Box is now open.
Oh, wait. Stop right there.
No, I am not going to pause it so we look at her boobs longer.
Oh, okay.
He Zorro'd the crap out of her dress.
Was that the secretary, or like who was that?
I have
that?
No idea.
How about Monday? When's that last he met? Well, thank
you. Goodbye. Man, those dentures are fucking up her speech.
Can I help you? We're looking for Lou
Dembski. What the fuck is she wearing now?
Canadian tuxedo.
That was her dogging outfit.
He went out. It would have been great if it had been like Sergeant Dembski, and I'm from the Red Dragon.
Is this him?
Yeah.
Kidding. I'm sorry. I can't take her serious with a goddamn bow in her hair.
She's had a bow in her hair.
She's got
like
a denim.
Four or five scenes already.
She's got a denim vest on.
That's right, Denim Dan.
Oh, no, that's
she's
dead.
Tough.
That
she's from
dead.
The streets.
He's going to run into Stingray's extracurricular activities and end up getting killed.
And you know how brutal Stingray can be.
Oh, yeah. It's terrible.
Damn money.
Who are you talking to, motherfucker?
He has no inner monologue, man.
So he can't do it in his head. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
Wow. Hey, we talked about inner monologue earlier today.
Yeah, culture is called a callback.
Oh.
Ever heard of it?
Reference shows that aren't watched by anybody.
Oh, that's true.
Yes, then we can. Our show's out. Yeah. Oh, it's all the eyes.
Wait a minute.
He's been keeping the eyes?
Oh, yeah.
Why wouldn't you?
Why would you have to pick it up to see as a fucking eyeball?
I don't know.
Well, it wasn't an aquarium. It's a little.
Well, he's retarded.
Okay, there's no scenario where I'm putting my hand in a goddamn aquarium.
I mean, it could have been a ghost shrimp.
What does Stingray
that's your
have
reaction?
Eyeballs in a fish tank for?
Can I say that my first reaction would then be to leave the building?
Whoa!
What the fuck, movie?
Like, do you really need to go open that to know what's going on?
Why? Okay. Bitch, can you not recognize human legs?
Okay. So wait a minute.
Having a nice time till you showed up.
Oh, boy.
Why would you say crazy?
Clearly, that
if
is
you're
what
trying
he
to
is.
Disarm the psychotic killer, yeah.
Who looked out for you when you came back from Japan? Me.
What was he doing in Japan?
Training.
He was learning all his crazy martial arts, duh.
Trying to get an
he
Okinawan
he has some of the craziest eyes.
Hi, Dana.
If only he had acting to go along with those eyes.
Yeah, he does not, though.
Wait, Wow. This looks bad.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Did you see it? Slender.
Is he like undefeatable or something?
Indefeatable. Man, get it right.
Yeah, it's unbelievable.
Oh!
None of this look good. How does everybody know martial arts in this and is wearing shoulder pads?
Well, one, they date Asians. Two, that was a good one, Slender. That one got me.
Can I talk about his nose real quickly?
No.
Okay.
What's wrong with his nose?
Yeah, I don't see anything wrong with his nose, actually. Of course I love you, sweetheart. What the fuck? What happened? That. I wore your favorite perfume. Yeah, what's wrong with his nose? I don't see anything wrong with it.
Wait, is she now trying to convince him that she's an Anna as
yes.
well?
Yeah, I guess he doesn't know what happens.
Maybe she's trying
I think she knows, but she's trying to bail, buy time.
Okay, yeah, rewind a little bit. Him. Okay, now. I want you to see his nose.
Okay. We've been looking at it the whole time.
Look at her nose.
It's in the middle of his face.
Okay.
I think she's thinking that if she buys time by all and basically moving into the casually Brahma right. category of victim.
Oh yeah.
It'll. Didn't she already try
the
this?
Safest and... way to go.
Yes. Yeah, it didn't work the first time.
Yeah. Oh, he's about to do his
this
move.
Might...
Oh,
yeah,
dude, he's gonna
do
the panty
memories.
Snatcher move.
Well, let's see it.
Oh, actually, is he into this?
I think
a little.
It's hard to tell.
He is a psychiatrist.
It always is. That's why you guys, you know, it's better to ask for forgiveness after, you know.
Is that the motto of the casual Brahma?
Yeah. If you're not sure, you know.
So we're about to experience Brahmaism. Be a good.
Well, we had a casual Brahma earlier in the movie.
Yeah. Hey, there's a theory of Brahmaism, and then there's being Brahmified. See what happens if you say, don't do something, how we're going to do it, over and over
again. And it all ends up in Brahma bull's milk.
Where will you? How many times have I told you to behave yourself? How many times have I told you to
behave
yourself?
Wait!
She
oh, now
about
she's
his mother.
His
issues.
Mother.
That's right. She knows the mother.
She
issues.
Figured it out.
I forgot about that thread. Wait! I was doing something. What happened? Oh no! Why did he chain up his mom? Wait, she has a cell phone?
No.
Yeah.
It better be
well,
the size.
She's...
Jennifer, are you there?
Hello.
What the fuck?
Jennifer, is that you?
Can you hear me now?
Help me! He's got me. What are you talking about?
Who's he?
Stingray's got me. I'm in the
why wouldn't you say start with Stingray got me instead of he got me?
Call the police.
Wait.
I'm on my way.
How does she know where he's
no,
at?
No, call the police. She said call the police.
Call the popo.
That was not the number for police. It's 911, you dumb bitch.
Yeah, and you don't usually have to put in coins for that.
Local emergency.
She called the non-emergency guys. She don't give a shit about this bitch.
Why do I feel like I stayed up late for no reason?
What? No, well, dude, I'm not going to cut out all of your audio.
Some, you get hits and misses.
Again, culture, it's 11:45 your time.
Yeah, what the fuck, dude? It's almost 2 here. You're like, oh, it's so late here. Stop eating dinner at 5.
Yeah, it's almost 3 in the morning here.
How often do you go to Golden Corral and get the matinee special?
Yes. Are you at the point where you automatically get the senior discount without even showing ID? Mommy?
How? He's a regular. They know him there.
He gets 39-cent coffee every morning at McDonald's.
Jennifer, run!
Oh no, cardboard boxes.
Why are they empty? Where are you?
Same place where they fought on top of those oil barrels.
Oh, man. That was the first time that I appreciated a woman being hit.
Did she got womb kicked right there.
By the way, he's so icky, he makes it uncomfortable to see him hit women, when normally that's the highlight of these movies. He has ruined women beating. wait, hold on. What Slender, the please fuck? Tell me you what? Saw that.
No.
Rewind.
No.
Rewind.
I already did. Watch, here it comes. She thumbs his ear?
Yeah, like, oh. Like, you could really
I
hurt
hate
your thumb
that shit.
Doing that.
Right? So, what the fuck? Why are there so
oh,
many
no.
bottles in here made
that,
out of sugar glass?
We saw her
oh,
training
Chekhov's hook
earlier.
Sword.
Oh, Chekhov's bottle. Chekhov's. Damn it. What are those things called? The
uh-oh,
fluffy things
go.
That come in package?
Peanuts. Oh, his sword packing is actually peanuts. Sharp.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, Chekhov's packing peanut.
Okay, so the chain's going to help here.
Wait, are they falling for each other?
I know.
I'm not sure that's the going on. I'm not sure that's the energy we're looking for.
I mean, that's what I'm getting. Look at those. Look at them. Got the smoky eyes.
Oh, Mad, you are
right. It looks
right.
Like a Harissimo.
Look, Chekhov's packing peanuts are being paid
damn.
Off.
Thanks, Chad. I almost missed it. Fucking paid off. Oh, y'all think Bullis is going to stop this motherfucker?
I forgot my sunglasses.
Wait. See, wait, is she in the sling for that little cut that was on her arm? Yes.
Uh-oh, that chick's
how
dead.
How is she not screaming?
She's about to be dead.
Because
and,
she doesn't know.
Dead and Canadian.
Wait, why are they going back up there?
He forgot his sunglasses. Something's
wrong. No kidding.
How do you
oh, no
know?
Shit.
It's just an empty chair.
Maybe she went to the bathroom, dude. Fuck, you're a detective. Figure this shit out.
That guy's really dead. No, he's not
well, hold on.
Dead. Why are you checking on him? No shit,
bro.
He just passed him in the hallway while he
yeah,
was.
Yeah, are
sitting.
You gonna?
How did he get dead?
I mean, if you pass someone, you are you gonna give him a heads up? There he is. No, he's already dead. There's no saving him. We don't have time to get him to another hospital. I mean, he has the dull side to her neck. Just shoot him in the head.
Maybe more. Actually, that might be 60.
Oh no,
that might be a $60 knife.
What the fuck?
Shoot
you
the
gave
hostage.
Him your gun? Great, now he's gonna shoot all of you. Oh, never mind, I forgot. Swear
on the
to Christ.
Plus side, at least we have a man fighting him now.
Oh, now he's gonna be defeatable?
Well, it's because it's not an Asian man. He throws them around like they're women.
Oh, yeah. Well, because
guy?
They don't weigh anything.
Yep.
That does seem
you
kind
got
of
that
racist.
Weight advantage.
Yep, that's what you get when you only eat rice.
Stop it.
What, you're not Asian?
I mean, I pretty much only eat rice because I love Asian food.
Well,
so.
And that in,
culture is
we all know what happens when you get to 200 pounds.
Yeah, I stop eating.
Oh, that hurt.
Wait, nobody makes me spit my own spit. That's a dodgeball.
What
reference.
The fuck is th- oh my god.
What? Did he do that with his fucking fingernails?
Yeah, he did.
I don't.
Yes, he did.
Uh-oh. Buy shirt.
And oh my god, he ripped the shirt off.
Yeah, that's the most important
style.
Part.
I feel like there's a lot of peacocking going on for
oh,
a death.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, this is the most I've been into this movie yet.
Of course
I
mean, it is.
I feel like this is the best moment.
You should know right now.
Man,
Mad
thank
is,
God he
like,
just stood there still while he got rid of the knife. I mean, put your fucking hands up, bro.
Yeah, it's not a lot of defense going.
Well, I guess since none of those are hitting, it's not that big of a deal.
And the guy who is getting hit is doing the yelling, not the guy who's throwing the punch.
It seems like they're hand. Yelling in unison, like they're like
yeah,
how they're gonna
maybe.
Come later. Man, foreplay was so different in the 90s for gay guys, right?
Is this like a Mr.
Oh.
and Mrs. Smith style
gouge
thing?
His eyes.
How many times have we seen dudes' faces hit the wall? Oh, wait, what? What is what? Okay,
like
I gotta
a,
rewind.
Did he hit
like
a code
needle?
Hitting the wall with his eyeball.
Okay, watch
out?
Watch his hand.
Watch okay, I'm watching.
Hand. Oh, there it is.
Wow, it's like
oh,
a shake.
I know.
He's jerking off that arm.
Okay. See, man, it was so much better to be gay in the 90s before they made marriage legal.
I know.
Because.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you see the shake weight action there? It was amazing.
Yeah. Because everything's forbidden, which makes it hotter.
Wait. Okay. So all I know is I heard of a towel boy.
I want to see what takes his eye out. Is it the hook?
Yeah. That was a nail.
It's the little thing to hang the towel on.
But that nail wasn't there before.
I think it was.
Yeah.
And it's 3 inches lower than the other nail holding the towel.
And who just puts a nail in a concrete wall?
Well, people who want to hang towels.
Get a
DIY
channel.
This guy,
he can explain it.
If I were this police officer, I would be really pissed at this bitch for robbing me of my glory like this.
Right?
Well, I don't.
Now he's never going to have sex with him.
You don't know that. Oh,
yeah, I don't think that thing was there.
That's right.
Yeah, I see it now. Right. No shit.
He kind of missed it, though, didn't he?
Yeah. Oh!
Like, that was nowhere near his eye.
No, that wasn't near his eye. Yeah. Okay, screaming's not going to get your eye back, guy.
This dude doesn't even have fucking depth perception or peripheral
Nothing.
Vision anymore.
He has no depth.
And he's still kicking the shit out of both of you.
Oh, this might hurt. Oh.
Oh.
Did they just got the other eye
Wait,
now.
Both? No, fuck you, movie.
Oh,
fuck
no!
Off. Fuck off, movie.
Now, that is cruel and unusual, what he just did.
Well, yeah, but you're not in a court of law or in prison.
Well, he is a police officer.
Yeah,
I'm not
sure he planned it. Keep an eye
out for you. The part where he reached up and pushed the button to lift this guy, he planned that.
Oh,
he didn't know.
God. Listen.
Okay.
Keep an
this
eye
is
out
the
and
this is
see
it.
You, really?
That was uncomfortable. Keep an eye
out. Let off some steam, Bennett.
Oh, okay. Did you hear the joke? Keep an eye out for you.
Yeah, we were see trying to hear the second one.
Oh, sorry. Okay, it was play it again.
No, that's all right. I'll fix it in post.
Yeah.
No, he's so sweaty.
I think it was just his name, Stevenson. He's not.
There it is.
Now they're going to tack on the. Now they're tacking on the romance that they never really developed throughout the course of this movie.
Is that the same cop? Is that the same cop that fought the dude?
The same cock.
Yeah.
I mean, cop. I mean, guy.
He looks so different with his shirt on. Ugh.
He's not nearly as interesting a person.
No.
Oh, there it is.
Fucking Asians.
Wow.
It's a hug. It's a fucking hug.
No, it's not.
And do you really mean me to believe that all three of your names are Wu?
Yes.
Our IQs are too high.
Our IQs are too high.
What? Dude, you can't do that. You can't enroll people.
It's a community college.
They're all they're all going to Harvard because they got it.
Hold on. Well, hold on. She was like, no, you three start on Monday. I enrolled all of you. And then he's like, I enrolled you. Can you just enroll people into college at this time?
You can't. Actually, back then, yeah. If you could establish that they were Asian and it had good grades, you could definitely enroll them.
Wait, I'm sorry. Even if you're not that person, nor do you have any
relations with them? No, these guys are going to Harvard, bitches. I'm just saying.
Also, the whole Asian and smart, isn't that self-evident by saying Asian?
Yeah, I think this is one of those films that actually identified with the idea that people could be, you know, brilliant.
Okay.
I haven't seen any of them in this
movie,
but okay.
I love that the secret, the underlining message here is people can be brilliant.
But yeah.
The themes. Whoa, let's see what everybody thought of the movie. Culture, don't make me snatch those panties.
I never got a chance to finish the steak. Oh, you guys fucking suck. Oh my God.
What voice
what?
Was that?
I think we broke culture.
That can't be cut.
Fucking... I mean, this is going to be the intro.
Have we even found out why?
I don't. I was actually thinking, I was like, shit, did I miss what happened?
This was definitely six out of nine.
Six out of nine.
Casual Brahma eyeballs.
Wait, what?
What the fuck does that mean?
Just like it means. Let it happen.
All right, Culture, do you have anything to promote?
I don't give two shits. Fucking
God. No, come on, promote something. What do you got coming on? You have like 20 theme streams, right?
Just
give us one.
Okay, all right.
The Tuesday tirade.
Oh shit.
I haven't done that in like a year. Let's
I know.
Okay, wait.
Okay. You can find me on That Park Play.
What the hell?
Okay, that's fine.
All right.
Hold your head a gummy.
Stop it. Don't tell people that. Yeah. No. Okay. Wait.
Have some unsweet tea. That's what I tell men.
Oh, no. I had sweet tea. I didn't know it was supposed to be unsweet.
No, that's what I drink.
What the hell, Mad?
Okay. Wait. Okay. Okay.
All right. We're ready. Ready?
I'm ready.
Yep.
Okay.
I am very super famous. Very super famous. A lot of people know I exist. I am very super famous. Very super famous. You are not, so you are shit.